day, and the cold temperatures are here, and they are sticking around for a bit longer for many of us. My name's Michelle Nelson. Thanks for joining us as we take a look at your national forecast. Already, we are dealing with some warnings in Ontario for that snow that we have that's moving across the province. Blowing snow will remain an issue for many of us. However, we do have some blowing snow warnings in, but also a snow squall warning. If you're traveling along the 401 from Cobourg towards Kingston, watch out for very limited visibility. And right along the shores of Huron, we have had a number of roads that have been closed because of the blowing snow and just the dangerous driving conditions. We've already seen 2 to 5 centimeters for many as of noon on Saturday. More is on the way. We have those pockets where we could see up to 15 centimeters. Arda O'Kell has been out braving the elements, and he joins us now from Port Hope. Arda? I think that's a good idea. Although we are dealing with blowing snow right across the province for today, especially further towards the south, not everybody is in that blowing snow warning that has been issued by Environment Canada. Here's how you get into that warning: at least 3 hours of blowing snow, sustained winds of 30 kilometers an hour or greater, but visibility reduced to 800 meters or less. That looks very heavy. We are looking at more snow, but it's a rain snow mix, so it's a really messy system that is heading your way for today, and the winds as well. If you're in Rec House, we could see peak wind gusts closer to 160 kilometers an hour through the overnight into your Sunday. This will ramp up for you in Newfoundland, but the entire province of Newfoundland is under that wind warning. Winds gusting to 130 kilometers an hour. That's possible as we head throughout the evening and into tomorrow. We are looking at those sustained winds right across the Maritimes. Those will remain strong throughout Sunday as well. And in terms of that mix, if you're in Nova Scotia, the rain, the snow, very messy for you. Further north, parts of New Brunswick, mainly snow, but Fredericton south, the mixing will continue. As we head towards your Sunday, we are going to see that system push east, and the rain, we could see up to 30 millimeters. So very messy, slushy, and slick conditions. That's what you can expect. Again, and that is leading to some slushy, slick conditions out on the road, but also poor visibility. My name's Michelle Nelson. Thanks for joining us. A happy Robbie Burns Day to you if you do celebrate. Let's take a look at some of those warnings. We do have that blowing snow, but also a snow squall warning. That's in effect further towards the east from Cobourg to Kingston. If you're heading right along that 401 corridor or Highway 2, watch out. Very low visibility is expected through Sunday in terms of just how much more snow we're expecting. We do have pockets of up to 15 centimeters, but this includes what we have already seen. Many have seen 2 to 5 centimeters in southern parts of Ontario. You could see another few centimeters within the greater Toronto area. A system making its way east into Atlantic Canada, that will be messy for you. It's not only the snow, but it's the snow-rain mix. Up to 30 centimeters further towards the north, Labrador, Quebec, mainly a snow story for you. Also for New Brunswick, but the winds are a huge story. Peak wind gusts over 100 kilometers an hour. More on your forecast coming up, but right now it's time to test our weather IQ. Polar vortex, it's not going anywhere, at least not yet. So how long will the cold last? We will have all those details. My name's Michelle Nelson. Let's talk about that active weather. Yesterday, it was so windy across Ontario. It was hard to get anywhere driving, but also just walking down the street. We are dealing with those winds still, but the worst is over. Blowing snow will remain an issue. We do have a blowing snow warning in effect, but again, right across southern Ontario, we are looking at that poor visibility. The snow squall is setting up along the shores of Lake Huron, but also further east from Cobourg towards Kingston. Very poor visibility there. We have had reports of some accidents today, so be careful out on the roads and take your time, but also the road closures. In terms of how much more we're expecting, up to 15 centimeters. That includes what we have already seen with the snow. Arda O'Kell has been in Port Hope, a very snowy scene there. He joins us now. And Arda, I'm glad I'm in here today. And you are under a wind warning, so you can expect those very gusty conditions to continue throughout this evening into tomorrow. It will really ramp up. We're looking at peak wind gusts closer to 130 kilometers an hour for Newfoundland. You are under that wind warning the entire province, but for Rec House, we could see winds gusting to 160. This afternoon, those are sustained winds in red, very windy conditions, not only for Newfoundland, but across the Maritimes. The system that's pushing in for you is going to be a messy one, from the rain to the snow. Snow for further towards the north into Quebec and Labrador, a snowy story, but a mixing story further south. That will continue to track east throughout the evening and overnight, winds ramping up along with that. And for your Sunday morning, if you're in St. John's, you can expect a rain-snow mix. Northern parts of Newfoundland, mainly snow for you there. Now from these wintry conditions, high. Further east across the prairies, we are seeing that snow for today. Expect blizzard-like conditions because the winds are going to be very strong, especially throughout the overnight. And along the foothills for your Sunday, we are tracking some snow, 2 to 5 centimeters for you in Alberta. Further east, a snowier story. In Winnipeg, we're not expecting too much snow, 2 to 5 centimeters. And speaking of Winnipeg, our very own Deb Medichka will be there all next week. So to find out where she is, you can head to her Twitter. But in terms of that snowfall, up to 10 centimeters for this weekend. Taking a look at conditions, if you are heading down south, let's start in the Dominican. If you're going to Puerto Plata, we are looking at 30 degrees, beautiful sunshine. For Punta Cana, 29, sunny skies as well. Really a beautiful time to head down south. A lot of sunshine, clear skies in your forecast. Cancun, Mexico, 28 degrees, hot conditions there. Don't forget the sunscreen. If you're heading to Jamaica, Montego Bay, 29 degrees, beautiful sunshine. Have a fabulous vacation.
The Weather Network's